So are you an SEO beginner and you just want to get to number one in Google? Well, great, because this video is for you. And what's quite amazing is that Google gives you so many free tools to help you to get to number one. So in this video, I'm going to split apart SEO so that you can understand it as a beginner. And then I'm going to show you the ingredients that makes up good SEO. I'm then going to clear out all the hype and all the rubbish and leave you with the good stuff that's going to make SEO work for you. With that ingredients, you can then build a good business in Google that's going to give you results in years to come. But firstly, let's just split apart that SEO atom of confusion. So what is SEO? Well, let's go right to the beginning. SEO stands for three words: search, engine, optimization. But the confusion is that there are now ways in which SEO is presented to a user. So if you're a business and you're wanting to be found on the search engines, not only are you now being found on several search engines like Bing and Google, but also you're then appealing to a particular type of audience, because many people are searching now on a local search. And that's the first key thing to understanding SEO, is there's two types of SEO. There's local SEO and there's organic SEO. And the two are very similar and they both have similar ingredients, but the proportion of those ingredients is slightly different. And this is the first part of the learning curve that no one seems to speak about, is the difference between local SEO and organic. And both work together well. So what is local SEO? Well, local SEO is quite a relatively new thing, really. You may have heard of Google My Business, Google Business Profile. Basically, local SEO is about giving people access to your business based on where they're searching from. So years ago, if you just did a search, you'd get the region of, say, your country providing you with results in your language. Whereas now it's much more done on a geographical basis. If you're searching for a haircut, you're going to want your haircut to be from a salon nearby. So Google understands that, and that's part of the local search. Businesses that are local to you. And how that's presented can vary, because a local business will be presented through maps, so Google Maps. It could be through Google search results. You may have heard of the map pack. So it comes through various ways. Whereas organic is much more of like a national generic based on the content, the keywords itself. And so local SEO uses the authority of organic SEO, but it does have the ingredients in a slightly different proportion, as you can see here. If we take, for example, Google My Business, so you can see there 36% it relies on for Google My Business authority, whereas on organic, just about 6% of the authority of Google My Business. So of course, for those of you that are familiar with this channel, you know that we focus a lot on local search and Google My Business or Google Business Profile. So if you want to know more about that, you need to have a look at that after this video. But in summary, you could say that the fundamental differences between local SEO and organic SEO is that local SEO is for optimizing for locations, while organic SEO is more about optimizing for content. But we're going to focus more on just general SEO. So I've been working particularly on a SEO rocket fuel, an ingredient that's going to give you the boost that you need to get to number one. So let's kind of split this apart then. And we've got all these like various parts of the ingredients as to how we can make up our SEO and get some great results. So splitting the SEO up, we've got KR as the first area, and this stands for keyword research. Thing is, how can you optimize for anything if you don't know what your searchers are looking for? So if you've got a business and you notice your customers are particularly looking for something and they keep using the same keyword or keyword phrase, that's what you need your content to be about, so that when people then do a search for those things, they're then going to come across your business, because your business has a blog or a post that's specifically talking about those keywords. But how do you know the right amount of keywords to put in? And how do you know who and what your audience are searching for? And one of the greatest tools, of course, that Google gives us is Google Search itself, because in more recent times, Google actually predicts what it is that a user is going to search for. So if you go to Google and you start typing in the keyword that you think your users are looking for, you just notice how it comes up with lots of other suggestions. And also, not only does it come up with suggestions there, but you'll notice that the content it produces in the results also mentions other things that are related to that. All the clues are there. All the keywords are there. All you need to do is just do a little bit of research beforehand, And that is a big chunk of producing great content that's going to get you to number one in the Google search engine. It's just knowing what it is that's currently being searched for. And these change as well. So you might think, well, I can't get to number one because everyone else is number one for this keyword. But new keywords come along. So just keep an open eye out for trends in your particular niche in your business. You know, the keyword intent can include informational, where people want answers. It can be commercial, because they want to actually compare things, maybe products. It can be transactional, because they want to find out what the cheapest place is, or they want to perhaps get a quote. And navigational is more that they're wanting to find how to get somewhere or to get to a specific place. So sometimes there's a problem, sometimes they're looking for a solution, sometimes they just want to get a brand understanding of your business. So what tools could you use then to help you with your keyword research? Well, Answer the Public's a really good way in which you can get information. So you can type in there a keyword and it'll provide you with questions. It'll provide you with what people are actually searching for. And you can then use something that's known as a long tail keyword. And it just means it's a little bit easier to find traffic for. The competition won't be so high, but it will get you some traffic. And as you get more traffic, you build authority. So Answer the Public's a really good, and I'll put a link down below if you want to go there. And also a couple other things as well. I've got a video here that speaks about 7 tools for keyword research. So this gives you 7 more tools if you wanted to really delve into keyword research. And one of those tools I use there is called Keywords Everywhere, which again is a great tool if you haven't used it. So that's one part, that's one quarter, one section of building this explosive rocket fuel that's going to get you to number one. But what else could we add to that? Well, UB, user behavior. It's about understanding your audience. Your audience wants a fast loading website. Google knows that, so it ranks you for that. Google also knows that they want it to be on all devices. So a tablet, a desktop, but particularly a mobile. In fact, when Google looks at your website, it just looks to see, is it mobile friendly? Does it work well? Does it load fast on a mobile? And you get ranking benefits from getting those things right. And you have to keep adjusting them, because things do change. You need to also make sure that your site is already being indexed by Google. So you can do a check by just typing in site into Google and then your domain name. And that will show you if it's been indexed and spidered. If it hasn't, you probably need to put a sitemap and XML, upload that. But the key thing is understanding how your audience works, how it wants to work with your website. Do the menus make sense? And you could just ask a friend to look at your website and to then give you some feedback, to give you almost an audit on how easy was it to find a certain item or a product on my business website. So we often talk of usability, user experience, user interface. Does the menu work? Is it updated? You'll know whether your website works or not, because people do feedback and say if it's not working great or not. So how can you test it? What tools do we have here that are free? Well, we mentioned Google provides a lot of free tools. If you go to Google and type in Google mobile test, there it will then show you how you can do a test. You can test to see the speed and to see whether it's mobile friendly. If you want the actual speed test, then you can go to pagespeed.web.dev. Again, I'll put links to these down below. Now at this point, if you use any other tools that I haven't mentioned, either keyword tools or tools that benefit your user experience, then just put them down in the comments below and share them with us so that we can all benefit them. And if it's a really good tool, I may even use it on my next video. So we've had KR, we've had UB, but the next part of the ingredients is QC. So what's QC stand for? Well, it's to do with quality content. Yes, the content that you produce needs to be better than anyone else's to get to number one. So if you do a search for something and what comes up as number one is a higher quality content than your content that you're producing, then it may well be hard to get to number one. But what do we mean by quality content? Well, just think, is it well written? We've mentioned keywords. Often using videos, embedding videos into the content too, keeps people on there. It becomes like stickable content where people don't want to leave it straight away. There's no bounce rate. Immediately people are showing to Google that they found answers to their queries in Google search engine. So quality content is key here. But to produce quality content, that can take time, takes research. Maybe you even need to see what others are doing first so you know what to do better. There's all the basic optimizations, of course, with SEO and quality content. You need to have keywords in the headings. You need to think about H2 tags, H1 tags, your alt tags. You need to think about the URL itself, making it mobile friendly, but also making it so that it's keyword friendly, so that URL actually has your keywords in. And if you've used the Yoast tool, you'll know that's absolutely perfect for producing those types of things. And your quality content needs to be linked from other quality websites. So you've got external linking in, internal linking in. So all these things add to its authority, builds up its ability to then show that it is high quality because people are linking through to it. But there's also the key of finding opportunities to let people know about your quality content. So how do you get these opportunities? Well, there's a brilliant tool here, it's free, it's called Can I Rank? Again, I'll put the link down below, but you notice here you can go to opportunities, and here then shows you some of the things that you can do to your website. So it spiders through it, it looks through, it's a free account, and it will then give you all the quick wins, all the authority websites out there that you could perhaps contact, maybe some keywords you haven't noticed that are bringing in great traffic. Maybe you could do some internal linking based on those keywords. This is going to add a quality and an authority, and it's easy opportunities. And so it will just show you again ways in which you can make sure that you really hit the nail on the head when it comes to QC, quality content. Now I cover this in a lot more detail on my 7 essential SEO tools, and I'll put a link to that video above so you can look at that after this video. And of course, if this video is giving you value, then make sure you give it a like down below and do comment. It really helps people find this video so that others can benefit too from these SEO tips. But we've also got LBs being floating around now. So what does LB mean? Well, we've already touched on it really, it's link building. But there's a difference between link building where it's just a casual thing, which often I've encouraged because I think if you've got good content, people will naturally want to link to it anyway. But one of the things that most SEO gurus say is the one thing that's been consistent through the whole of SEO over the 30 years or so now is link building still brings in great traffic and helps you rank higher. And you can't avoid that. So how can you link build with even more authority? What can you do to find opportunities? Well, first of all, you've got to make sure that Google is linked to you. So you can do so by making sure that you've got Google Console loaded, and that will then show you what pages have been spidered. It'll also make sure that it shows you what keywords are bringing in the traffic. And actually, you can't really do without analytics or Google Console, Google Search Console. And also, there was a new Google update on the console recently, and I put an article together that shows you how you can use it and how you can optimize your business by using the Google Console and how you can add it to your website, particularly if it's a WordPress website. Then there's a few other tools you can use as well. There's a SiteKit tool that takes the analytics and the console together and outputs a really simple, ideal for beginners, a really simple way of presenting the information, which is a much easier way than if you go to analytics, it can be quite confusing sometimes. Also, the Search Console enables you to upload an XML sitemap. And an XML sitemap is a sitemap that's used purely so that Google knows what new pages have been added to your website. I mean, you can understand that you're never going to get to number one in Google search engine if Google doesn't know what's on your website, what your keywords are, what your content is. So this XML sitemap just keeps Google updated. It just lets Google know when you've done an update on your website. It just tickles Google Spider to come and see it and then make sure that it then puts it back into its database so it can show it to your potential clients. So as a bonus, I've also got a video that shows you how you can add SiteKit to your website, particularly if it's a WordPress website. It's pretty easy to do, but the results are fantastic. So there's a video that I'll put a link to in a moment that will help you to do that. But as I mentioned earlier, ranking first is only one part of it. SEO is not just about organic, but it's also about local SEO. So how can you now get your business to also come up top in the Google Maps and top in the local searching? Well, to do that, I produced another video that you must watch because it's going to fill in all those gaps the Google Business Profile will then fill in to bring in higher rankings for your business on Google. I'll see you on that video.